Hello and welcome. In this video series, we will start looking at the space activation device, and we will start very, very simplistic with our high voltage transformer via our little driver to the transformer, and we will use very, very little power so that we come to a voltage below 10,000 volt, and we measure then the reaction over time. So I have done such kind of tests already. So we measure also the temperature, so it will heat up, it will become warm. We have always the same power. We are using 11 volt and 210 milliampere precisely. We will not get higher. It stays fixed at this value. Things will change that become apparent, and also things will change in terms of once we are switching off the device. So there is a residue then left after the system is switched off, which will continue to work. I can also say that then follow-up sessions will come where we charge the batteries. I have done that already. So I activated the system for 6 hours, 7 hours. Things did change. I charged the battery, and the battery did charge in a fraction of a time. So we will investigate that in details. We will see what kind of energy then is then extracted, or energy is then provided to a storage system in a different, faster way. So we're going to look at the traditional way of charging, looking at the traditional time and power consumption, and then do the same measurement after our space is activated. The slight problem we have is once the space is activated, we cannot simply switch it off. Even if I switch off the device, the space is activated. So whatever I do then is in the environment activated and will fall under the same category. So that means it will charge faster. Things already changed as well. So here in my kitchen, in my house, cooking was faster. So that means food were much faster prepared than usual. So such things will become apparent, but that is something we have to do in long-term investigation of something like that. So we are starting in the beginning just on that device itself. This device does change, you will see that, which should not be the case. We are using 33 ohm here, so that we have the limitation. We're gonna go always with the same power in here, but things do change. So I will not go too much details that you will see what's going to happen, and we measure that over time. I will plot all the information on a chart. Here we have always the same value, but here that is important. Here voltage, that means the high voltage will be plotted on a chart over time. I will take some measurements for the temperature as well. So I probably have to wait now 1 or 2 days before I can do the next scene, when the activated space is decreasing, so that I can go back to a ground state where I started off, and I will continue with my next video clip from this day on. ¶¶